Yo, yo, what is up, family? CPA Strength here, strongest CPA in Florida. How's everybody doing? I've had like a crazy morning, nothing was working, but I'm here now. And through all the technical difficulties, let's get this in. Dude, we here, man. We're kind of getting to be like a nice little mature a series here. This is your first time. Welcome. If this is your 30-something, 50-somethings video, thanks for coming back. If you want to see the best playlist, best accounting playlist on the YouTubes, hit up here, because that's what it is. Accounting for Beginners, number 32. Can you believe we made it this far? Let's go. What are we going to do in the 32nd installment of the classic series? The classic series. What are we going to do? We're going to do another adjusting entry like we did in the other one. Like we did in 31, we did depreciation. We're going to do adjusting entries. CPA Strength, JD Blaze is going to do adjusting entries today. I'm going to do a prepaid expense. I'm going to do a prepaid expense today. You guys ready? Are you ready? Because I'm ready. Prepaid expense. Before we go any further, boy's getting big. Height and weight, jacked and tan. Thank you very little. Just the entries. We're gonna do a prepaid expense. Right, before we do anything, write this out in your paper. I already know you have it on your paper. Thank you very much. Good students, you're not lazy. If you're lazy, write this on your paper. If you have no idea what this is, refer to my older videos. DC aid alert, debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. Prepaid expenses, here's what we're gonna do. Let's just stop and think about it a little bit. Prepaid expense. So it's an expense that I've prepaid. I paid for the expense before I used it. Prepaid, that's what kind of prepaid. I paid for something and I'm gonna use it at a later time. That's what your prepayment is, right? On December 1st, you paid $2,400 for 1 year insurance. When you pay for something a year at a time, it's in the middle of your year, because December 31st is the end of the year. Now you're not gonna do all your annual subscriptions on January 1st, so they're gonna be in the middle of the year sometime. This one, you found a new insurance company, good deal. You got a good deal, you couldn't pass it up. You said, I'm gonna get my insurance December 1st. So the journal entry for that is, because you have cash, the journal entry on December 1st is, let's always do our cash first. You pay $2,400, so you have cash leaving. Cash is an asset, you have asset leaving the business, so you would credit it. So you credit the cash for $2,400, is our journal entry. What is the debit? Now let's think about this. What do you have the outlay of money for? You have the outlay of money for insurance for a whole year. Have you used any of the insurance at December 1st yet? No, you haven't used it. You haven't used any of it. It's all a prepay. A prepaid insurance is also an asset. Right? You just traded this asset for another asset. It's like ready to go for you. In my head, it's kind of like buying, like in our other one, like it's like depreciating office equipment. Like you have equipment here that's going to be lasting for years and years or multiple periods, and you would expense as you use it. Basically, that would be depreciation. So that's kind of what prepaid insurance or prepaid expense is. You have it ready to go. You haven't used any of it. You haven't used it yet, so you haven't expensed it yet. So that's an asset. Prepaid insurance or prepaid whatever is an asset because it's there ready for you to use. Think you haven't used it yet. You just took an asset to get this asset. Thing is, let's make an adjusting entry for the end of the year. 12/31. Most businesses. I guess, what is that called? A calendar year. Most businesses that I work with are in a calendar year. 12/31 is the end of the accounting cycle, the end of the period. Unless I say anything, all my examples are going to be 12/31. I think it's just easier for everyone to remember. It's not as complicated for these basics. 12/31 is the end of our accounting cycle. And you want to make an adjusting entry for the end of the year. So now we're gonna have to do some. Now we're gonna have to do some calculations. But now the dates kind of make are a little more important. So we'd have to write a 12/31 here. All right, now we're gonna make our December 31st, but December 31st is gonna be our adjusting journal entry for our prepaid expense. Now you gotta think, all right, I mean, there's a bunch of different ways. I'm gonna start with 2,400 was the whole, how much you paid for the whole year. So 2,400, 12 months, $2,400 divided by 12 months, $200 per month. $200 per month is how much you're using of the insurance of your prepaid insurance. Is how much you are using. Now you gotta think. All right. So you know it's $200. You've had the insurance for a month. Now you can either do the debit or the credit. We get a different color here. Now you can either do the debit or the credit here to make the adjusting entry. It's up to you, whatever makes more sense to you on this. And this is kind of a trickier one. It's a prepaid expense because insurance usually is an expense. Now you have it as an asset. So I don't know, would you know if if this is given journal entry for you already, and you say make an adjusting entry for end of the year based on this journal entry that was already done, well, let's think about it. Insurance is usually an expense. It's usually something that you pay out in order for your business to go and make more money, you know, to be safe and have things. So insurance is usually an expense. Now you have it on the books as an asset because you've prepaid for it. So at the end of the year, you're thinking, well, how much have I used and how much am I gonna use as an expense for this year? So in this journal entry, you're gonna have an expense. Okay, what do you think? Probably gonna be insurance expense because that's what prepaid insurance is for. So we're gonna have debit of insurance expense, debit expense right here. It's a pot in the normal balances, it would be a debit. So we're gonna have insurance expense. All right, so we got insurance expense for our debit. Now how much? This is December 31st here, and we bought the prepaid at December 1st, so a month has gone by. So how much have we used this? So a month has gone by, 2,400 divided by 12 months, it's $200 per month. So in 1 month, we've used $200 worth of our prepaid insurance. So $200 is the amount of our debit for insurance expense. $200 insurance expense is our debit. Okay, what's our credit? Let's go, come on. Do you guys know it? This is hard. I'm gonna say this is hard. This is kind of maybe an intermediate thing in my opinion here, but bear with me here. We're gonna have $200 as our credit, yes. We've already used cash to put this on the books. We just kind of traded. We had cash here. We had cash in our bank account. We basically gave our cash away before to get this in place of cash. This is kind of almost a cash. Usually for an expense, if you pay it right away, the credit would be a cash credit. But before you've prepaid, so you've kind of made the, you've turned the cash into a prepaid insurance account, you've used, now prepaid insurance is an asset, you've used some of that prepaid insurance up. You've used $200 of that prepaid insurance up. So that's the account that we're gonna credit here, prepaid insurance. So journal entry is make adjusting entry for end of the year for the December 1st, paid $2,400 for 1 year insurance. This makes sense because you've had the insurance for a month, you've used $200 of it, that's the debit insurance expense. You want to lessen this account by $200. So if you go to your T account or whatever, so what's in the prepaid insurance account? See, it's an asset, and that was the debit. So you had it for $2,400. Now you've minused it for $200. So the prepaid asset account has $2,200 left, 11 months more. Anyways, I hope you liked it. This was kind of an intermediate